A UK pub owner received a letter of apology 21 years after the crime was committed. My name's Michael McCrudden, talking to you about One Guilty Conscience, my favorite Eminem song by the way, here for you on IO. Before we jump into this video, I need to let you guys in on some very, very, very big news. IO and IO Trends is rolling out the red carpet for one special guest. Her name is Vita Chambers. I can't stop how I'm feeling. It's like I need you. And if you let me, I can fix you. Vita is a Juno-nominated artist who has been the opening act for the likes of Justin Bieber. And this video you're watching right now, Fix You, has received gold status on the Canadian Billboard chart. Yeah, she's kind of a big deal, and she's doing an interview with me, both here on IO and on IO Trends. By the way, the girl is very hubba hubba. Now let's get back to the crazy story about the pub. Frances Cunningham got a letter addressed to her at the Swetenham Arms near Congleton in Cheshire after a break-in at the country pub 21 years ago. She can't remember the break-in, which apparently caused some damage to the cigarette machine. Watson, we have a break in the case. We must follow the cigarette butts. The letter came in the mail with the thief's name and their info listed, which Frances isn't sharing with anyone. Darn it, Watson, the case goes cold again. The letter read, Dear Mrs. Cunningham, I was involved in a burglary at your business in 1992. I didn't break in or smash up the cigarette machine, but I was there and I went in. I'm very, very, very sorry. I did not realize the seriousness of my actions at the time. I had been through a lot and had no idea what to get help would be like or how to do it. The burglar went on to say that they feel ashamed because this may have caused some fear and some financial costs to the business. The letter continued, I wish I could take it back. I hope that you will never be bothered by such cruelty ever again. Yours sincerely. P.S. If there are any further costs, let me know. Also with the letter was a £25 note. A little bit of payment for harm done. Miss Cunningham took that money and donated it to charity. But if it were me, well, I would have written the person back and I would have went on to say, you know, when you broke in, it really gave us a bad reputation. Customers stopped showing up. Soon after, the water broke, the basement got flooded. We couldn't repair them because we no longer had customers. Everything is on the fritz. It all broke down and it's all because of you. You now owe me 100,000 K. I'm just kidding, but that's an idea. My name is Michael McCrudden. Be sure to let me know what you think about this story in the links down below. Also, in the description box, we have a link for you to find out more information on this beautiful story. And yes, I know, there's no basements in the UK.